One of my viewers, Lawrence Gracie, asked a number of good questions, which I really want to explore in regards to the possibility of XRP being split for institutional and retail markets. Hi, this is Jeff with the HODL Report. Join me on today's video as we take a look at the potential divide of XRP by institutional users from retail buyers, traders, and really look at who or how this could actually happen. If you enjoyed today's video, please remember to give a thumbs up, leave some comments, subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I do want to take a moment to thank all of my subscribers. We keep reaching new levels. I'm now over 2,200 subscribers. This past week, my channel began to monetize. And as the money does come in, even though it's really small amounts, I plan to give it back to the community at this point. And I'm really open to suggestions of how. So leave some comments below and let me know what your thoughts are. Now, over the past week, a number of YouTubers have been discussing a theory which has become known as the Hexagon theory, which was posted on Twitter by Hexagon 7536-7509. You can look it up again, Hexagon 7536-7509. Now, Hexagon broke the theory down over the course of 18 tweets. From November 28th, I believe it was. So you can go onto Twitter, check it out. You can decide for your own about the theory, but make sure you go and read it. And like I said, come up to your own opinion. Now, I understand the premise of the theory, and it does seem like a logical argument. However, I do not see how the market can be split unless the theory is really somehow referring to a bulk buy discount by institutions, and therefore they're exchanging at slightly different rates. Really, I went back and looked and tried to identify a precedence for a dual exchange as a typical standard financial mechanism, whereby splitting the currency into different exchange values. Now, there is such a thing as a dual exchange, which can occur really as a way to alleviate financial pressures, providing a fixed exchange and a floating exchange where essential products to the economy will get preferential exchange rates. But again, this is typically during financial crisis or other type of crisis to alleviate financial pressures. It's not a typical standard protocol. But what I want to do is actually look at this concept from a slightly different approach. And really the question here would be, could the retail investor be blocked or banned from buying, trading, or potentially even holding XRP in favor of an institution-centric XRP, essentially really a push to make XRP a banker-only token? Now, banks, large financial institutions, and governments could potentially want an exclusive solution. I get it. I've searched through the Ripple developer site, and I really haven't found anything in the protocol that would provide a mechanism by which large groups could push out the retail investor, or could they? And this is what we want to explore today. So let's look at some of the potential external influences that could separate the retail market from XRP, from the institutions. Now, number one on the list that we can look at would be government regulation and license requirements. Now, I believe if this was going to happen, it would have taken place and would have happened already. Plus, there would have to be really a blanket regulation on all digital assets, not just one specific digital asset, not just the XRP, really something similar to what's happened in India, where they're basically banning the transaction of digital assets. So I don't think at this point that would necessarily be the course of action. So let's move on to the next one, which is wallet regulation. Now here, this would be a mechanism to really limit the access of retail investors to manage or hold XRP wallets. Now, again, I believe that if there's to be some sort of government regulation on a specific wallet, it would really have to be global across all digital assets. It couldn't just single out one digital asset. So I believe it's unlikely to happen. However, the government could potentially sanction a specific digital asset or a digital asset wallet. But in order to sanction, there would have to be something illicit tied to the entire digital asset and the purpose for the wallets to begin with. And I do believe that by trying to sanction or you know, force people out of the digital wallet, it would somehow infringe on constitutional rights to property if the individuals were actually sanctioned and the financial institutions were not sanctioned. Maybe there's some other mechanism in there, but I don't see that at this point. I don't see that occurring. Now, XRP reserve amounts. I covered this, the XRP reserve amounts, in a previous video, and this is really one of the possible scenarios that I believe could have some merit, could potentially gain some legs. But there's really a what if, and it's really just a hypothetical here. If we go back to the premise of my other video and really looking into what could potentially happen, but there currently is a specific 20 XRP reserve minimum requirement on all new XRP wallets that are opened. The point that I made in the previous video is that if the price of XRP goes up, and the reserve really remains unchanged, stays at 20 XRP, the cost of opening a new wallet could potentially become cost prohibitive to the retail investor. Now, there is a mechanism in place that allows the minimum reserve requirement to be changed, to be adjusted based on a consensus of the validator. So I think this is really important that the reserve amount can be brought down as the price of XRP goes up. Now, I'm not saying that the reserve price will go up. I'm not saying that that could happen, or I'm not saying that my next statement is going to happen either. But what if a majority of the validators are controlled by financial institutions and banks, and then they can actually reach a consensus to adjust the reserve minimum up to a much higher level? So let's say, for argument's sake, let's say that XRP is currently at $10. The minimum reserve amount remains unchanged at 20 XRP. So the reserve cost of opening a new wallet would essentially be $200. Now, through consensus, let's say they could raise it to 100 XRP or 1,000 XRP. And again, I'm not saying that this will happen. I'm not saying it could happen. But let's say that if it did, it could actually reach a level that's no longer affordable for the average retail investor, but relatively insignificant for the bank or the financial institutions that are transacting in millions, hundreds of millions, or not, if not billions of dollars. So opening a $10,000 wallet would be relatively insignificant for the bank. Now, the other mechanism here could be pricing. Now, liquidity, as we all know, is needed by the banks and the financial institutions in order to move the trillions of dollars in daily transactions that are needed for the cross-border payments. Now, to accommodate this, the price of XRP will ultimately need to be pushed up. Now, XRP price on its own will not necessarily impact the ability of a retail investor to buy XRP. It may be a demotivator if the price gets to a high point where it's not really perceived to have any additional potential for upward momentum, upward movement. If we look at Bitcoin, for an example, when Bitcoin was at $20,000, there was obviously significant hype around it at that point. but the pool of individuals that were willing to actually invest, even if it was just a fraction of a Bitcoin, the pool shrank down of those who were willing to invest. And this is actually a reason why many of us actually went out in search of alternate coins like XRP in the first place. So a demotivator. However, individuals can still buy fractions, but if it's not, if you don't have a perception of that coin going up, then you are going to be demotivated to buy. Now, again, this on its own isn't necessarily going to block a retail buyer. It's just going to limit the pool of potential retail buyers. Now, if you combine pricing with the minimum reserve amount, whether it's increased or kept where it is right now, then you might have a good combination that could block an even larger percentage of potential investors from the retail XRP market. But again, you're not really blocking everybody. You're not in essence having a complete institutional takeover. And again, this is all hypothetical to start with, that the institutions, the financial institutions and the banks could take over all of the validators to a percentage that would allow them to have a consensus in their favor. Now, I believe there's other factors at play here that would actually go against specific government regulation. I gotta believe there's some sort of government regulation that could potentially or would prevent this type of collusion or monopolistic behavior on the part of the banks. Now, governments and banks will continue to maintain a specific amount of control over the financial markets. I think that's a foregone conclusion. However, the digital asset market has shown us that the general public is very, very resilient and has found a mechanism to begin to move beyond complete control, beyond manipulation, and beyond the potential for corruption of the financial institutions. Now, the government and the financial institutions, for the most part, were nodding off at the wheel as the blockchain digital asset market jumped in front of the vehicle and has caused the entire status quo fiat economy to really swerve off course. Now we're bumping down the shoulder on a path to an entirely new road, one that is digitally paved. If you enjoyed today's video, please give a thumbs up, leave some comments below, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and a parting comment before I go. Please invest based on what you can afford. Invest based on what you can afford to lose. Don't buy or sell based on the FUD or FOMO that's spread online. And make sure, above all, do your own research. That's very, very important. Do your own research before you decide to invest basically in anything. With that, I look forward to seeing you on my next video, and keep on hodling your crypto.